Hi everyone, my name is Srihari Jayaraman. I'm a student of IIM Tiruchirappalli. Today, let's briefly talk about the India's manufacturing sector and what we can do to enhance its competitiveness. First of all, let us understand the importance of a manufacturing sector in an economy. Time and again, studies have revealed that the major economies like China or even emerging economies like Vietnam or even some of the grown economies like Korea, the lesson learned is very clear. When the manufacturing did well, they were able to offer employment to a number of people, which in turn helped people to come out of poverty. Also, manufacturing has forward and backward linkages with agriculture. In terms of some of the industries takes agricultural input, which might also boost agriculture. And manufacturing uses logistics in order to move raw materials, finished goods, as well as work in progress, which will also boost logistics, which is the service industry. When you look at all the Asian economies, India is a very unique economy, wherein the growth has been predominantly attained by services. If you look at China, China's GDP growth is majorly attained by manufacturing, while that of Vietnam is a balance of manufacturing and service. India is the only economy that has attained a great level of growth predominantly by its services. If you look at one statistics, by 2010, Vietnam's global export was $72 billion, whereas that of India was $220 billion. But as of 2019, both India and Vietnam were expecting almost around $320 billion. India per capita growth in the last 15 years, India ranks 3 in the Asia. If you would have done well with the manufacturing sector, probably we might have overtaken Vietnam and came very, very close to China. Now let's understand what are the various reasons why the manufacturing sector in India did not grow. One, India, the manufacturing sector is a high resource intense sector, which is one of the reasons. Second, we have a very high burdensome compliance and regulatory requirement, which is one of the reasons for the stagnation in manufacturing. Thirdly, acquiring lands for manufacturing as well as a dysfunctional policy framework contributed to the stagnation in this sector. Okay, now let's look at a global, one of the other reasons is also the lack of infrastructure. For example, India takes almost over 50 days in order to get in a good and in order to turn around a good, while the rest of the Asian counterparts are doing that in single digits. Similarly, in order to take a good from the factory to the port, it takes almost 9 days in India, while it takes less than 2 days in Vietnam and China, despite the fact India has a bigger coastal line than Vietnam. All right, now what are the things that we need to do in order to improve the competitiveness? We need to understand what the grown economies has done, like the US and the UK. After the 2008 crisis, almost all of these countries embarked into free trade agreements and also had focused sectoral reforms. On top of that, they made a number of infrastructural investments, and since 2008, over 100 countries have a very clear industrial policy. Right, exactly as this follows, the solution to our problem is having a clear industrial policy. India's last industrial policy was made in 1991, which may not be enough as a lot have changed in these last 30 years. So the industrial policy, we need not have government intervention like that we had in 1991, but the government is expected to play a facilitator or a promoter of trade in this sector. India has to invest a lot in infrastructure. While we have a lot of people in the country, we need to build the skills to make them employable. Third, the government has to play the role of an organizer by connecting all the domestic players in order to represent the foreign counterparts. And we also need to focus on integrating us into the global value chain so that we become a very clear export-oriented economy. On top of that, we also need to simplify doing business and continuously reduce the bureaucracies and improve our ease of business doing ranking. And last but not the least, the service sector had gained because of less regulatory labor burden, and similarly lot of that burdensome labor regulatory requirements need to be removed. If you do all of this, I'm pretty confident India could add at least $320 billion in the global value chain in the last 7 years as per the McKinsey report. And I hope India will do that. Thank you so much.